everyone. Sean Heath, the PA voice for the Dallas Mavericks. Now I've cleared my schedule to excitedly present...
The View, high above our broadcast location tonight, the Staples Center in Los Angeles. Hello, everyone. Proud to bring you Wednesday night coverage of the NBA on 2K Sports. We'll watch the Portland Trail Blazers in this one as they go up against the Los Angeles Clippers here at the Staples Center. This is Kevin Harlan joined by Greg Anthony, Steve Smith, and on the sideline, David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Thank you, Kevin. Paul George has shown over the years that he remains one of the most versatile stars in the league. He said, "I pride myself on being effective on both ends. I try to do it all. Play the right way and just get lost in the game. I'll do everything I can to win." And guys, there's still not much he can't do with his combination of size and athleticism.
David, he clearly is a special talent, and his resume shows it. Thank you. Taking a look here at some of the numbers for Nicholas Batum.
And you can see the surge in his level of confidence lately. Just by looking at that true shooting percentage, it's been moving straight up in the past five games. I think he's feeling it.
The starters for the Portland Trail Blazers. At the guard spots, longtime teammates Lillard and McCollum. Powell and Covington up at the forward. And it's Nurkic in at the center, filling out the middle. And for the Clippers, the post pairing, Batum and Zubats. Jackson is out there at Bledsoe. And it's George in at the three, the small forward. Early on here, Greg, we already see some second-year players looking much improved over their rookie seasons.
Yeah, and if you put in the work, you're not guessing as much. You're comfortable now with the speed and physicality of the game. And I know I cut way back on my turnovers at the start of my second year.
And the whistle blows as the basket counts. And a three-point play chance right here. One free throw coming up.
And for his position, Bledsoe probably as physical as any in our game. Clearly not afraid to challenge defenders.
Fans, and honestly, sometimes even us broadcasters, especially can overlook defense, Steve, especially when it comes to guards.
It's hard to spot great defensive guards, but Eric Bledsoe, Kevin, is certainly one of those guys. Very strong on the ball. He's been a first-team all-defensive member.
Mind the lanes.
Remember, back in 2019-20 season, Bledsoe was a key part of the Bucks' D, which was first in the league in team defensive rating.
An underrated two-way player. Bledsoe wows you with his offense, but he's also made the all-defensive first team.
Now here's Lillard to the paint. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
He was able to simply lay it in over the top of the smaller man.
George finds Batum, and it's rebounded by Covington. McCollum deciding where to go with it. Unloads from nine. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
Nice touch there from McCollum. Looking comfortable and confident from that range.
Here's George, and it's George finishing it off.
And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand, and he's the one doing the slam.
Agreed. He is smooth as silk, even on a power finish. And Bledsoe has it in the corner. Zubats trying to break loose. And there's Bledsoe on the assist from Jackson.
I like when Reggie Jackson is seeking out his teammates. He could have took that shot, but his teammate, he was wide open.
First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
You know, you're going to have success when you can start out shooting 80% from the game. So early offensively, they've been great. That's the way you like to start.
Now here's McCollum. Some stats for him. He averages over 21 points a game. Batum with the steal. And Bledsoe has it in the corner. Portland grabs the miss.
He liked to have that one back. That's easy money.
Powell for three. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum.
Fast-paced play from Norman Powell. Doesn't waste time finding his shot once he has the ball.
And George with the stuff.
Oh, how about using the rim to get some true hang time?
You know, he just wanted to make sure the landing was softer than the takeoff. knocks it loose. Batum against Lillard. Here's Bledsoe. Here's Jackson. A beautiful reverse layup. Jackson's got his second bucket. And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for Los Angeles.
Their aggressiveness on D has been the most glaring aspect of this game so far. They have the heat turned all the way up in this first half.
And also defensively, they've been able to cause some turnovers tonight, and that also builds confidence and gives you momentum.
Here's Nurkic. The Clippers getting the bucket. And pushing it up, here's Los Angeles, and George gets it to go.
Oh, great ball movement there.
And it's Willard with the ball. He brings it up for Portland. It's a 10-point game. Last time they came together was in Los Angeles, where they fell to the Clippers.
Well, when you're facing a team that's feeding off the crowd's energy, you have to bring your A game. And they didn't do that defensively.
It looked like there were communication breakdowns all night. Deadly, especially when you're on the road.
George, no good.
This is the shot you want, right at the rim. He just couldn't deliver.
Stolen by Zubats. George with the ball. Now defended by McCullough. Takes the assist and lays it in. Pick out the pass nicely.
Those defenders just look a little bit gassed. I mean, they're getting pushed around on that low block.
Poked loose. Batum with the steal. And it's George finishing it off.
Boy, that was quick. Already out to a double-digit lead.
This has been a beatdown right here. Possibly over before it began.
And oh, here we go with George. Nobody back. And then George with the jam.
Letting it all hang out. When George takes flight, just enjoy the show.
Awesome display of athleticism captured by your AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Not loose. And it's out of bounds to Portland. They'll retain possession. Let's take a moment now to check out the top scorers around the league. Fifth best, Paul George.
And his contribution to his team offensively cannot be understated. He is always leading the way for them with his ability to put up points.
Now, here's Nurkic. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against the Clippers.
And how about the job he did rebounding as well, guys? I mean, just the dominant performance on the glass.
Here's Jackson. Zubac trying to break loose. Jackson misses. Trailblazers trail by 11. They get a hand on it, and the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by George.
And a chance here to look at the numbers for Jackson. Averaging 17 points per game, 4 assists, and 3 rebounds. And with his skill set on the offensive end, he is such a threat on the floor.
I love it because he does so many things well. Defenses have to account for him even when he's not scoring.
Stolen by Jackson. And here comes Jackson leading the fast break. And he gets the bucket. 12 points for Paul George.
And you look at it, 8 of the last 10 points they've given up here coming in transition.
Down low, here's Powell. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum.
And we talk about court awareness. There, McCollum doing a beautiful job spotting the open man.
Now, here is George. From 8 feet away, he drops it in. George has got 14 points.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score consistently.
Oh, that's good. Clippers leading by 11. Here's Jackson. Fouled on the shot and picks up 2 points. So one free throw coming up.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
That's his second personal foul. Second team foul.
And he's got his first chance at the line here. The Trailblazers making a switch here. Nance has checked in.
One shot.
One shot.
And that one falls for Jackson.
You know, he was the 24th pick in 2011. I think it's safe for us to say Jackson's outplayed that draft slot.
Lillard, the pass to Nurkic, and finished off by Nurkic.
And that's a little lack of fight at the defensive end.
Absolutely. At least on that slam, you're right. That's one way to let a team back in the game.
Yeah, defensively, your mantra at this point has to be no easy buckets.
Just no resistance on the inside. That's their fifth consecutive make in the paint.
Now Lillard. He had 27 points last game. Now the pass to Nurkic. Good on the shot.
And such a polished player near the basket. Nurkic feels comfortable taking those in-close shots.
Here's George. Takes it off the glass. George has got 16 points.
Adding to this lead, he's been dependable and consistent at the offensive end.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's key to staying fresh all the way to the final whistle.
And, Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
For the Clippers, Serge Ibaka has checked in for Zubac. Justice Winslow comes in for Nicholas Batum. And it's Luke Kennard in for Reggie Jackson. And Portland with a change here too. Zeller's checked in. Now here's McCollum. 7 points in the game. Powell, no one around him. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum. McCollum's got 5 assists in the game. George with the bucket, and that's 18 points for George.
His shot making has been superb this quarter. He's taken over this game.
And Luke Kennard signing a 4-year deal at the end of 2020. Steve, this team feels he can be a big part of their future.
Yeah, a lot of people were surprised at the size of the contract, Kevin, but it shows how much the three-pointer is valued in the NBA. The Clippers saw he provides a much-needed aspect.
Here's Lillard. Paul George making his last shot. And the foul on Eric Bledsoe. That's his first foul. Simon, he's checked in for C.J. McCollum.
Substitution. And for Anthony Simon.
Zeller with it. His last outing, he had 8 points. Three-pointer, Simon. Trains the three-pointer. Simons has got it back down to single digits for the Trailblazers. Now, here is George. He's guarded closer. An easy 2 points on the layup. George has got 22.
Building up a big early lead, they have taken charge of this game.
Play calling has been fantastic. They've been a step ahead of the defense since the opening tip.
The Trailblazers shooting their first free throws of this
game. And in terms of team numbers, the free throw percentage is right at 74.
First one falls for. And so Zeller nails both of them. And so Ibaka will bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. They have a 9-point lead, fresh from a win against Portland.
And the difference in that one, the efficiency from range. They really focused on getting good looks.
And if it wasn't there, each guy was willing to make the extra pass, trust in his teammates.
Inside, Powell kicks to Lillard. Traps in the tray.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the triple. Four of their last five makes are from beyond the arc.
Good work there as a coach. Bledsoe's got nine.
And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
I'll tell you, this was their strategy coming in. They obviously identified a weakness there inside.
The shot's good.
And what I like about Nance Jr. is how he positions himself, knows his strengths on offense, and plays to them.
For three, Bledsoe. Nance with the rebound. Trailblazers trail by eight. Powell with it. It's Ibaka picking him up. And here's the fast break. Winslow's leading the way. Kennard kicks to Winslow. No good on the three.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
And the foul on Eric Bledsoe. It's his third foul of the game.
Timeout. Already. Now if you're the coach, you got to think about sitting him down.
Man's checked in for Los Angeles. Jackson comes in for Eric Bledsoe. And the Clippers decide to take their first timeout here.
Well, it's a player's lead, but certainly coaching has its place.
Yeah, if that weren't the case, you wouldn't see so many coaching changes in the offseason.
Here's Simons. He's been a reliable scorer for him as he's averaging up over 13 points a game. To the inside, Zeller. And the dunk by Zeller.
And didn't do anything fancy there, but didn't need to.
Nope, he is only concerned right now is getting the points on the board. I don't mean style points.
With good size for a two-guard, Luke Kennard can finish in the paint.
Lillard, the pass to Zeller. And he stuffs it. What a pass to set him up.
I'll tell you what, I'm not sure these guys can keep this up.
Yeah, both teams in the zone early. Stops have been almost impossible to come by.
Good on the three-point shot.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
2 minutes remaining.
Now here's Bob. He's tightly guarded. Here's Mann. Pushes it down to finish the break.
Agile play to get his hand in there and get the steal. Intelligent play to immediately start the break.
1:51 left to play here in the first. Got a piece of it. And here comes Jackson leading the fast break. That's in. That's his fifth field goal. He's shooting a hot 71%. 5-for-7. Trailblazers trail by 13. Into the lane, and it's in. Basket number 6 for him thus far. He has only missed 2 shots from the floor.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Jackson's gone 75% from the field. 6 baskets in 8 attempts. Lillard, the pass to Nance. Lillard with it. Now guarded by Winslow. Back to Nance. Some nice ball movement here by the Trailblazers. Pocket 6. 3-pointer, Simon. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Lillard. Lillard's got 5 assists in the game. Mann passes to Winslow. That one's in. His first bucket of the game. He's 1 for 2.
And you can't help but pick their defense apart. They're completely in disarray.
And the rejection by Jackson. Ibaka pushes to Winslow. Out of bounds. Portland takes possession.
Portland basketball.
Here's Lillard. His scoring totals are something to take note of. He's averaging over 19 points a game. And the official signaled the backcourt violation. Not very careful there. Five seconds left in the first quarter. Let's it go with a three. Nailed from three-point land.
Three-point basket.
Lillard's got his second bucket of the night.
Such a lethal outside sniper. Lillard isn't bashful at looking to pull the trigger from deep.
Winslow, and it's blocked. Poked away. Three-pointer, Lillard. Serge Ibaka with the rebound. Pass to Jackson. Here's Mann. Just 3 on the clock. It's good. The assist this time from Jackson.
Puts it in for 2.
Jackson's got his 6th assist on the night.
I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already here is eye-opening.
And so it's the Los Angeles Clippers looking at a 13-point lead heading into the next quarter. They've had active hands and have forced a lot of turnovers in this one. And don't go away. We'll be right back. Now with the talent around him, Damian Lillard able to play off the ball. He explained how that helps him get open.
Getting the ball later in possessions when the defense isn't so sharp. You know, usually at the beginning of a defensive possession is get over the first screen. You know, the energy is up. They're interested. And usually at about 12 seconds, they're a little tired. The interest goes down.
Well, Damian Lillard, Greg, accustomed to making shots with the clock winding down.
They have a phrase for it. Whether the defense is locked in or not, that clock is ticking down to Dame time.
Robert Cunnington.
And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. Guys, we've seen a confident-looking Clippers team out there.
Well, credit their anticipation skills on the defensive end. They forced a number of turnovers.
And you can't cause those mistakes unless you're willing to gamble. So far, they've rolled the dice, and it's paid off.
In a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. Taking a look at Los Angeles. Jackson is the point with Kennard on the wing. Winslow is out there with Ibaka, and it's Mann in at the 3. Here's Simons. Kennard covering. Not as good in the Los Angeles lead. It's cut to just 9 on the basket from Simons. See, back in 2002, you led the NBA at three-point shooting at over 47% a game. How would you have liked playing today?
I would have loved it, Kevin. The reason why I could have shot more threes. With more threes, gives you more stats. With more stats, gives you the bag.
On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Paul George has taken some heat in recent years. He says people get so caught up in what other folks think. I'm Paul George. I don't care to be anybody else. I am who I am. You love it or you don't. Simple as that. Guys, with his player on the floor, he has answered all of his critics.
He is certainly playing at an elite level. DA, thank you. Here's Lillard. We're starting the second quarter, about a minute gone. The drive by Jackson.
The flat-out speed of Reggie Jackson no struggles getting to the rim, and then doing something about it when he gets there.
And here's the fast break. Winslow's leading the way. Three-pointer. It's not going to go for him. And the Trailblazers going the other way. Last game matched up with the Clippers. A tough loss there.
Yeah, I mean, on the road, tough environment. They were right there, but just missed some key shots.
And you know, so often, that's what it comes down to. Who can convert when it matters most?
So, for the Clippers, Ivica Zubac has checked in for Serge Ibaka. And it's Batum in for Justice Winslow. And a switch here also for Portland. C.J. McCollum, he's checked in for Lillard. Clippers leading by 14. Here's Jackson. And that's a foul. It's called on Reggie Jackson. That's his first foul.
Yeah, another turnover there. But guys, overall, they've taken really good care of the basketball.
And so it's Covington who brings up the ball for Portland. That puts them squarely in the middle of this five-game road trip. Passes it to McCollum. And the rejection by Jackson. Pass to Mann. It's stolen by Nance. Batum against McCollum. Again, the miss by the Trailblazers. The Clippers have gone 3-4 from the floor here in the second quarter. And Covington sends it back. And they get it back. Batum, good.
Back in the day, someone would have blocked him out, but times have changed.
Tipped away. Batum with the steal. There's the drive. And Batum throws it down.
He takes advantage of him in every way possible.
And Greg, he lures them into a trap on the steal. And then bang, straight to the bucket.
Great activity at both ends. Great teamwork as well.
And the length that Batum provides on the wing. Smitty, great for both sides of the ball.
It makes switching on picks so much easier, GA. Nicholas Batum has been a solid defender his whole career, in large part due to that unbelievable wingspan.
Nurkic, the pass to Simons. Knocked away. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up.
Oh, the officials are all over that one. 17 foul.
The Trailblazers have been perfect at the line so far, albeit just two for two.
Two shots.
First free throw is good. So he gets them both. Clippers leading by 16. Driving the lane. And he goes in for the dunk.
Exploding to the rim. Luke Kennard slams it in. His offensive energy is a difference maker.
Ball's knocked loose. And here comes the break. Jumps up. Throws down the breakaway jam.
Well, there you go. One team operating on all cylinders at both ends. Steals, fast break buckets, and the other team in scramble mode.
Trailblazers trail by 20. The pass to Nurkic.
I got him.
Closing in on 4 minutes played here in the second quarter. Batum with the ball. Now defended by McCollum. Mann passes to Jackson. To the paint. Here's Zubac. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
Nicely done. They continue to attack inside, and that's 10 points in a row in the paint.
To the middle. Here's Nurkic. And finished off by Nurkic.
And you can't allow Nurkic to get that kind of position. When you do, he is going to rattle that rim.
Zubats kicks to Jackson. Launches a three. That one's not going to go. Now Portland takes it the other way. It's McCollum on the wing. Kennard covering. Left side, Covington. Nabbing another steal. And that's his sixth steal of the night.
Imposing his will at the defensive end. I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
And he's got his first free throw of the game.
At the line for your Clippers. At the free throw line, Nicholas Batum. Two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one drops.
Batum brings length and a versatile game to his spot on the wing, and his defense always a big asset for this team. He's the kind of player that everybody needs to have out there, kind of a glue guy.
George has checked in for the Clippers. Bledsoe comes in for Reggie Jackson. And so he makes both from the line. Simons has got the ball here for the Portland Trail Blazers. Fires the three, and another three for Portland.
And you can tell he's looking for his shot. He just believes in it.
You know why? Success breeds confidence, and he's certainly been successful from there time and time again.
Matching baskets from the perimeter, an earmark of today's game.
Hey, players love competition, and the fans love it as well.
Here's Nurkic, kicks it out to McCollum. And the Trailblazers, another three.
And this team's struggles are not his fault. He's putting in work at the offensive end.
Here's Bledsoe. Score the basket. It's number six for him this game. 6 for 9, 67% shooting.
And sometimes it really seems Bledsoe is better finishing through contact, almost like he enjoys the challenge.
And it's out of bounds to Portland. They'll retain possession. Nance passes to Covington. It's hauled in by George. Clippers leading by 21. And it's Paul George with the finish.
Capable of flat out torching you. Once PG-13 gets into a groove, watch out.
For Portland, they've gone 6-12 in the second quarter, right at the 50% mark from the field. And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by George. Norman Powell's checked in for the Trailblazers.
Teams will line up for the Trailblazers. Norman Powell.
Down low, here's Nance. He kicks it to Nurkic. That one a little long.
And I was sure that was money on that one, but everyone is afforded an easy miss too.
Yes, let's look on the bright side. You got a great look. It's a play that you might want to go back to again.
And they're getting points. They're getting stops. And this is how they'd like to play all the time.
Yes, when it's going good, it feels easy. These are the nights you relish, but they're tough to replicate.
And it's going to be out of bounds. The Trailblazers will take
Trailblazers ball.
Portland's gotten out from three-point land in the second quarter, going 4-5 from downtown. And it's out of bounds. The Trailblazers able to retain possession here. hits Powell on the wing.
An incredible defender. Paul George's combination of quickness and length helps alter many shots.
It's been a rough quarter for him. Can't seem to find any kind of rhythm.
And George with the stuff.
Of the two offenses here tonight, you can tell theirs is just a bit more in sync.
They've had better patience, better shot selection so far, but we still have a long way to go.
Bledsoe left side. Over Nance. No good from Bledsoe.
Easy chance from mid-range. Wouldn't be surprised to see them run that play again.
Nance passes to Nurkic. And finish off by Nurkic.
Clearly, he's one of the best there is in the business when it comes to making that lead pass.
And George, here we go. And he gets it to go. George has got 32 points.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Nance finds McCollum. Back to Nance. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum.
Attacking the defense with the pass. Don't need to be a hero.
Powell with the steal. Knocked away. The drive by Nance. And the jam by Larry Nance.
And it's in Larry Nance Jr.'s blood. Remember, his dad, Larry Sr., won the first ever dunk contest.
The Clippers again turning it over. Winslow's checked in for the Clippers. And then for the Trailblazers, Cody Zeller comes in for Robert Covington. And Damian Lillard is subbed in for Nance. And it's Lillard with the ball. He brings it up for the Portland Trailblazers. Zubac with it. Now guarded by Nurkic. Here's George. Portland grabs the miss. Here's Lillard. He's got six. McCollum dishes to Lillard. Winslow against Lillard. Here's Mann. Down it goes for his third basket in as many tries.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And Steve, we know about Paul George, a fantastic outside shooter. He's been an elite three-point artist for some time.
Paul George can get a shot up over most defenders. That's why, Kevin, has a career three-point percentage that's creeping towards 40%. And he seems to be getting better with age.
And that one's good, George.
So smart with the ball in his hands. George reads the floor well and takes advantage of what's there.
Lillard scanning the floor. Kicks it to McCollum. Now the feed to Nurkic. And no good that time. So Los Angeles will take it the other way. Here's Mann. And a great assist by Bledsoe as that one goes in. Bledsoe's got his third assist on the night. McCollum outside to the inside. Nurkic. And it's sent back by George. Los Angeles has gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Yes, that goes in. That's 36 points for Paul George.
And he has just been in a flow offensively. Terrific game. He has been the X factor. They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
And that one's good, Lillard.
High offensive IQ. He makes great reads and adjustments on the fly.
Here's George, and George with the stuff.
And with those long strides, it takes Paul George no time to get to the rim.
125 left in the first half. McCollum finds. Oh!
The assist.
Here he comes, and there he goes.
Look at him punish that rim. Here's Mann. Zubac trying to break loose. Mann can't hit. And the Trailblazers shooting 46% on their attempts in the second quarter. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Lillard.
Basketball.
And the Clippers making a change here. Kennard checked in.
Luke Kennard.
And And Los Angeles, guys, shooting has been sensational. 75% for the game. And George gets it to go.
Excellent concentration from Paul George, overwhelming the aggressive defense with his strength and determination.
Kennard with the rebound. To the middle. And George with the stuff.
Oh, big finish. Emphatic.
He hangs on the rim just for good measure. Wow. And taking care of the ball has been a problem for him.
That's something they've got to fix. While the defense has been good, a lot of these turnovers have been unforced.
One of the cases where height fails to tell you the whole story.
Los Angeles calls timeout. Los Angeles has gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. And it's George finishing it off.
I mean, he is explosive with his leaping ability. Paul George is well-versed in finishing above the rim.
And so it's McCollum with it. He brings it up for Portland. About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Lillard with no one around. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum. McCollum's got 9 assists in the game. Great passing. Here's George. And it's Paul George with the finish.
Man, it's really hard to knock George off his balance. He's just so long and strong. Nice take there.
Bledsoe against Lillard. Over Bledsoe. Paul George, he's been the guy making things happen for the LA Clippers. Offensively, this has been his best game of the season. This is the most points he's scored all year. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Here with Ty Lue. Good rhythm for your offense in the first half. What did you like about the start?
Moving the basketball, taking the right shot, making the right play. We make the extra pass, we're a tough team to beat.
And you were sure tough in the first half, Coach. Thanks. Back to you.
Okay, David, much appreciated. And now time for halftime. So we'll be back in just a bit to get the third quarter underway.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the 2K Sports Halftime Program. I'm Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Paul George taking care of business in this one. He went on an historic scoring frenzy, tallying a ridiculous number of points, 3 steals, and 2 blocks. And taking a look at the Clippers, Kenny, what did you see out there?
They were in such a groove that entire first half, especially the offense. Good play calling, good execution, and by and large, they take good, not good, great shots.
Shaq, how do you think Portland played?
First question, why can't they hold on to the ball? Loose as heck with it, Ernie. Not even getting a shot up on several possessions. Even if you take a bad shot, there's a chance it goes in or you get an offensive board. But hold on to the ball.
And that does it for our halftime show. We now take you back to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third period.
As we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next 2 quarters are any different from the first 2. So far, it has been a runaway. It's been one outstanding game from George.
As impressive as the block totals are from him early on, they don't even tell the whole story. He's changed countless others.
Yes, defensively, what they've done, they've funneled people his way and banking on his ability to intimidate.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. And for Portland, they're shooting impressively throughout at 62%. On the court right now for the Trailblazers. Covington is at the four with Nurkic at the five. Out of the wings for him, McCollum and Powell. And it's Lillard in at the point guard position. Now here's Lillard. And they call an illegal screen here.
Beyond the leaning, you could see his feet weren't set on that screen. Easy call.
So difficult to stay planted, especially with all the motion around you. Annoying turnover.
How about that mobile one block we just saw? Amazing defensive work.
And boy, did he get up quick to reject that shot. That's as fundamental as defense gets.
George against McCollum. Kept alive. Jackson. And he banks in the layup. Jackson's got 4 points this quarter.
A rare offensive rebound for Reggie Jackson, but he knows what to do with it once he gets it.
McCollum against Zubac. And a wide open look for McCollum. Finds himself wide open and drills it.
Easy look from mid-range. He won't miss many of those. Lazy effort defensively.
And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up.
And we all know what George brings offensively. But it's his ability as a defender that stands out. Great instincts to make plays on that end of the floor.
And with Paul George and his defense, Greg, you almost forget how great of an impact it makes.
He just kind of flies under the radar with his defensive play. I mean, this guy could be considered for the Defensive Player of the Year almost every year. One of the more disruptive forces on that end of the floor.
And the first one at the line is good.
The all-around game Paul George possesses is so special. His versatility is what makes him so valuable.
That one falls, so he hits both of them. And here are the Blazers. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Thank you, Kevin. Well, mid-range jumpers are something of a lost art these days. They're still practiced by superstars like Kawhi Leonard. Coach Ty Lue said, why not work on the shots that teams are giving up? Down the stretch, mid-range shots win games. Playoffs, too. If you shoot it at a high clip, it's just as good as a three for me. Guys?
And they do shoot it at a good clip, and they rely on it quite a bit. David, thank you. Four on the clock. Here's Covington. Good. Great play by Lillard to set it up. Covington's got 7 points in the game.
You know, often we think of Dame as a scorer first, but they're reminding us of his great ability to pass the rock. And defensively, they're on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Lillard, the pass to Powell, to the paint, and the dunk by Covington.
Great floor awareness. Powell knows how to find his open teammates.
George finds Batum. It's hauled in by the Trailblazers. Covington's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Inside, and the dunk by Covington.
A little undersized at the four, but he can get off the ground.
The Clippers have gone 3-6 in the third quarter, 50% from the field. Jackson misses.
Empty possession, and you don't want to miss these easy looks.
The three from McCollum, and another three for Portland.
McCollum. And you can't give McCollum any space. Always a threat to pull the trigger.
Jackson drives in, banked in off the glass. And it's now 26 points for Reggie Jackson.
Shots are just flowing for him right now, having a really strong quarter.
And it's going to be out of bounds. The Trailblazers will take it. J. just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half. Lillard, the pass to McCollum, and that one, good. McCollum's got 7 points for the quarter.
And what a fantastic start here to the second half. They have yet to miss.
Jackson, that's a two-pointer, and that misses badly. Air ball. Trailblazers have gone as spotless. 6 of 6 from the field since taking the court here in the second half. McCollum, no good. And it's Batum with the ball, bringing it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. Shoots. They get it back. And another one!
My goodness. 50 for the game.
Yep, he is putting on a show. And for Portland, they're shooting so well, 63%, the offense working as one cohesive unit. Lillard finds Nurkic, down low, Powell. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
And as good as his offense has been, Norman Powell's calling card since he entered the league is his defense.
And Smitty, what makes Powell such a great defender? Clearly he has the tools.
Yes, Kevin. He has good awareness, that's one. Lateral quickness, and he's very physical, and he puts that 6'11 wingspan to use.
Los Angeles calls timeout. Checked in for the Clippers. Larry Nance has checked in for the Trailblazers.
Oh, take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one.
You know, every team is looking for guys like Norman Powell. An explosive athlete who is relentless, and he can shoot the ball.
Simons, he's checked in for Portland. And so Powell nails both of them. Clippers have gone just a bit under 50% from the field since halftime. 5 out of 11. And the dunk by Batum.
Trying to attack the heart of that defense with great teamwork.
Trailblazers have gone 6 of 8 on field goal attempts in the third. A 75% clip. Here's George. And it comes off the front of the rim. The Trailblazers shooting in offensive execution has been beyond great there. 63% from the floor in this game. Gets the three-pointer to fall.
And really, as the three-pointers keep dropping, you get the sense that the frustration is mounting for the defense.
No good from Bledsoe. For Portland, they've gone 7-9 from the field to start this second half. Some tremendous shooting from them. That shot wide open. Simons has got 2 now from beyond the arc in the third for Portland. Here's Batum. He clangs that one off the back iron and down the ball. Batum's got 16.
I like what he's doing here. Terrific efficiency scoring the basketball.
Back to Lillard. And here is Powell. 17 points in the game. Excellent D there from George. And Batum kicks to Bledsoe. And there's the drive. And foul on the shot. So he'll get a chance at the line.
And how about that drive by Bledsoe? Goes right into the D and gets himself fouled while shooting.
And a closer look here at the scoring breakdown for the Clippers.
From mid-range, they've been on fire today. Those jump shots have been falling all game.
Yeah, and also the way they've been able to generate points off of the turnovers that they forced tonight has also helped.
And he can't get the first one. The Trailblazers making a switch here. Zeller's checked in. And he's good on the second. Portland's gotten the three ball working for them in the second half. They've hit three out of three shots from long range. Pass to Simon. They get a hand on it. Stolen by Bledsoe. Ball going up court. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact. It's on Damian Lillard.
Defense throws everything at George, but he persists and finds a shot.
For Los Angeles, they have shot the ball well from the free throw line, 8 of 9.
And their success rate on the season, right around 77%.
That free throw good from George. George drops them both. Now Lillard. 12 points for him. The dish to Zeller. Back to Lillard. And right on through for another basket. He's got 5 made on 5 of 9 shooting.
No excuse giving Lillard that kind of positioning. That's just too easy.
They get it again. And that's good. A nice job in the glass as they pick up 2 on the second effort.
He's not looking at the score. He's staying focused, and he's staying active.
There's 2 things they rely on him for. Being competitive and bringing energy. Great timing. That can be the difference between an assist and a turnover.
From the baseline. Shot is good off the back rim and in. Ibaka's got 7 points in the game.
And that set them apart today, guys. Their success with the mid-range.
Here's Lillard. Softly drops in the floor.
Timeout.
And just putting his entire offensive imagination on full display. What a smooth release from Lillard.
And the Clippers call time here.
Well, we talk about the clutch scoring of Damian Lillard. I'll put it in black and white. Since he entered the league in 2012, nobody has more makes in the last 20 seconds of a game to tie or go ahead. Nobody.
Winslow's checked in for Batum. Mann comes in for George. And it's Luke Kennard in for Eric Lutzer. The Clippers shooting it well here in the third, about 50%. And the list of players with multiple series clinching buzzer beaters in the playoffs, Michael Jordan and Damian Lillard.
And with a little bon voyage wave of the hand for good measure, Dame time is as real as it gets.
Jackson from long range. And he's good on the three ball. Jackson's got 9 points now in just the second half. Portland's gotten the three ball working for them in the second half. They've hit 3 out of 3 shots from long range. Cloaked loose. They're running. Here's Winslow. Good on the bucket. Winslow's got his second basket.
Obstacle in his way. Winslow, undeterred, finishes through contact.
At the elbow, Zeller. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist.
Assist from
and 12 points for Cody Zeller.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Trailblazers shooting 66% right now. This offense getting everything they want out there. And Portland turns it over again.
LA basketball.
And so Ibaka will bring it up for the Los Angeles Clippers. That one drops for him. And that's 31 points for Reggie Jackson.
That is a powerful point guard right there. Reggie converting against very tight defense.
That's tipped. Stolen by Jackson. Here's Kennard. It's good. The assist this time from Jackson. Jackson's got assist number 8 now on the night. Lillard, the pass to Zeller. Simons from outside. He's off on that one. And the Clippers will go the other way with it. Here's Mann. And he didn't get quite enough under that one. Lillard from outside. Scores the bucket. He's 7 for 11 and continues to look good.
And they have been relentless from deep. And you see the defense trying to react, but to no avail.
You know what? They talked about this at halftime, and they're doing a better job of creating space.
Nance dishes to Zeller, and it's blocked.
Good timing by Justice Winslow with the long arm to get a hand on that shot.
Los Angeles with another miss. Portland's gotten 12 of their points from long range in the third quarter, going 4 of 5 shooting.
That's what happens when nothing goes your way. You start to lose focus, and it makes matters worse.
Here's Jackson. He's got 31. Shoots over Covington. There's Winslow. Misses off the right iron.
No other way to put it. Just a poor shooting performance for him. But luckily, his teammates have picked up the slack.
Got that bucket in no time at all. Lillard's got 10 points here in the second half.
You love to see Lillard this fired up on offense. Gives his entire squad a big boost of energy.
Here's Simons. And blocked. That one goes careening off the glass. Here's Jackson. And the dunk by Jackson.
And you're seeing it with Jackson tonight. When he gets in a real rhythm, man, he can light up the scoreboard.
The Trailblazers shooting 64%. Beautiful all-around play by this offense. Simons, the pass to Zeller. And the rejection by Ibaka. Winslow's shot is off. And here's Portland. And they're running. Here's Simons. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
That's his first personal foul.
2 shots.
Second team foul.
Elbow. 2.
This is his second trip to the line in this one.
And for Nate Simons, 2 shots.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
First free throw is good. McCollum's checked in for Lillard. Good on both.
Wow, they've made every free throw here in the second half.
LA's gone 1 of 3 from downtown since halftime. Zeller with it. 12 points for him. Here's Simons. Nance outside. To the middle. Wants to get it to Zeller and does. And that one goes. Feeding him with the lead pass.
and so far going for more of an inside presence here in the second half, getting away from the three-point shot.
Ibaka lays it up off the glass. 9 points for Serge Ibaka.
Something that's really evolved for Ibaka, the ability to absorb contact while maintaining control.
And Ibaka slams it in.
He takes advantage of them in every way possible.
And Greg, he lures them into a trap on the steal, and then bang, straight to the bucket.
Great activity at both ends. Great teamwork as well.
Got a piece of it. McCollum kicks to Zeller. McCollum outside. Kennard against McCollum. Kennard's shot is off.
And for his offense, this has just been a brutal period.
Pass to Simons. Covington trying to break free, and he drops it in from the low post. Simons has got 10 points now just in this quarter. Here's Mann. And Ibaka slams it in.
When shots go up, one thing about Ibaka, he gets to the right place at the right time.
And Simons has got the ball here for the Portland Trailblazers. Pass to Nance. McCollum outside. To the paint. Here's Zeller. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Winslow's got 6 rebounds in the game. That's a 2 from Kennard. It's hauled in by the Trailblazers. 4 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Simons from outside. And another 3 for Portland.
Trying to slice into this deficit every time up the floor. Terrific quarter for him.
Covington with a steal. There's the pass to Simons. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum. McCollum's got 10 assists here tonight. So active. A nice shot by Winslow. Winslow's got 6 points.
Didn't really have a clear opening in there, but Winslow, an unstoppable force.
Here's McCollum. Misses. And so it's Los Angeles, finishing the quarter up by a whopping 24 points. From the field, they have been outstanding, amazing shooting. That's what has them headed to a blowout. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. And let's go back to a terrific pass that we're calling tonight our State Farm Assist of the Game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feat.
Fundamental basketball. Keep your eyes up. Keep the ball moving. You're going to keep the defense on its heels.
We reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. So with George on the bench, here's who Teron Lew's going with. Jackson is the point with Kennard on the wing. Ivica Zubac is out there with Justice Winslow. And it's man in at the small forward position. Well, Greg, for those of us who have never played in the league, what's it like traveling all over the country over the course of a long regular season?
Come on, Kevin. I bet you had a nice J back in the day. But seriously, it's a whirlwind tour, man. Sometimes you don't even know what city you wake up in. And I can tell you, there have been many times where I'm going back to the front desk complaining because my key didn't work, and only to find out I was using the wrong key.
The free throw drops for Jackson, and the Clippers making a change here. Bledsoe's checked in, and a switch here also for Portland. Lillard's checked in. And good on the second, so he makes them both. Here's McCollum. Pass to Zeller. Lillard outside. Poked away. Kennard with the ball. Lillard picks him up. Here's Winslow. Finish off the break.
This is the consistency he was looking for in the first half. Just took him a while to heat up.
passes to Nurkic. Now here's Powell, guarded by Bledsoe. Back to Nurkic, kicks it out to Lillard, six to shoot. Over Winslow. Lillard misses. The Clippers shooting 65%, an outstanding offensive display from them. Winslow's shot is off. And for Portland, they're shooting impressively throughout at 62%. Here's McCollum. Got a piece of it. Bledsoe looking around. Shoots over Lillard. And it's off the back rim. No good. And here are the Trailblazers now. He feeds it to Zeller. Kennard with the rebound. Kennard's got his fourth rebound in this one. There's Winslow, and the dunk by Winslow.
This is a big kid who can handle the ball. Winslow off the dribble drive.
To the inside. And there's Zeller. That's good on the assist by Lillard. Lillard's got assist number 10 tonight with that last one. On the wing, Winslow. Zeller grabs the board. Zeller's got rebound number 8 now on the night. Cullen passes to Zeller. And the dunk by Zeller.
And he placed that pass out in front of him and let him just run into it in rhythm.
Clippers have gone 2 for 5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter. Bledsoe gets that one through the hole, making 7 of 13 in this game.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
Here's Lillard. Oh, and he pucks it off the glass. Wow. Zeller against Winslow. And the layup's good off the glass. Winslow's got 6 here in this quarter.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference in points in the paint between the two teams.
Powell, the pass to Nurkic. And the rejection by Zubats. And pushing it up, here's Los Angeles. Here's Bledsoe. And the layup is good. And that's 19 points for Eric Bledsoe.
No hesitation at all in transition, and they have a huge margin in that department.
Powell for 3, and it's good. Assisting on the play was Lillard.
That's who you want to get it out to. Norman Powell shoots around 40% from deep almost every year.
You know, he was a non-factor in that first half, but now he's making up for lost time.
And here's Lillard. He brings it up for the Trailblazers. Nurkic against Zubats. And he comes up with the deuce.
His team is down because he's not shooting enough. There's no reason he shouldn't be getting more looks right now.
Here's Kennard. Nurkic with the block.
And that 7-2 wingspan for Nurkic, he can just gobble up shots. He knocks that one away with authority.
Trailblazers have gotten just under 45% of their attempts to drop in the fourth. 4 of 9. Bledsoe dishes to Jackson. Here he goes. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Jackson's got 37.
They're consistently finding ways to get the ball inside and taking full advantage.
Stolen by Jackson. Pass to Zubats. And there it is for him.
Man, just adding insult to injury. He just waltzes inside and extends this lead.
A uncontested shot at the rim. You have to compete at all times.
From 11 feet away. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. Clippers have gone 8 of 14 from the floor here in the fourth quarter. Kennard's shot is off.
Trying to finish out the game strong. You have to recognize who has the hot hand and get him the ball.
And the call will be against Yusuf Nurkic. That's his third foul of the game.
In the first half, he got wild and loose from beyond the arc. Now he's hit 3 more since. Remarkable.
So Portland ends up going with the new group. Clippers shooting 53% from the field in the fourth quarter. Can't ask for more than that from your offense. A nice shot by Hartenstein.
A solid playmaker. Bledsoe has the vision to take advantage of an imbalanced defense.
And McLemore kicks to Brown. And the pass to Ellaby. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Ellaby's got himself on the board with three there.
And that's back-to-back threes. The D just seems to be slacking off a little bit.
And I'm sure next time he sits down, coach is going to have a few choice words for him with that shot selection.
And you know what? He knows it. You have to try to play within the system or you're going to come away with empty possessions.
Tony Snell. Snell, that's good.
Tony Snell gives you plenty of size out of the backcourt. Doesn't always attack inside as much as he could.
And the Clippers call time here. Greg, you've got the unique opportunity right now to watch your son Cole follow in your footsteps. What has changed for players now versus when you played?
Well, I think the players today are so much smarter, and they prepare to be pros at such an earlier age. And honestly, I think that's one of the advantages our league has. You know, you don't have to teach these guys responsibility. You may have to teach them the game. But they are ready, willing, and able to work to achieve their goals.
Going to turn it over. They couldn't get it inbounds that time.
Yeah, I guess when you're up this big, you can afford to get a little sloppy.
Loose. Little passes to Ellaby. Brown outside. Here's the floater. Misses from close range. And for the Clippers, they're shooting a superb 63% from the field. No good from Bledsoe. Here's Hartenstein. And he uses the glass on the layup. Hartenstein's got four this quarter.
Poor interior defense. If you play him soft, he's going to kill you.
Ellaby, the pass to Brock. And Greg, with recent legal results, more opportunities now for compensation for college athletes. Do you like it?
I do. I mean, there's enough money going around. I don't have a problem with the athletes getting a share. Especially with the amount of time and effort and energy they have to commit. Let's take care of the guys. Let them enjoy the collegiate experience.
Snell, the pass to Ellaby. Tries a three. Eric Bledsoe with the rebound. And it's Bledsoe with the ball for the Los Angeles Clippers. Top of the key jumper, no good. Inside. And it's Whittle finishing it off.
You gotta love his aggressiveness to finish inside.
Well, his leaping ability gives him a great advantage. No good from Bledsoe. Portland's gone 3 of 4 from downtown here in the fourth. Here's McLemore. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
That's his first
personal foul. Yeah, easy call.
First team foul. At the line for the Trailblazers, Ben McLemore. At the line for two.
Take a break. 2 shots.
First free throw is good. Nicholas Batum. He's checked in for Eric Bledsoe. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. Steve, you played 4 years at Michigan State with all the changes, including pro options for the top prospects. Do you worry at all about the college game?
No, I don't worry about it. In some ways, having more players who stick around is a good thing. But I love the opportunity these young guys are getting. Continuity can lead to beautiful basketball. They just have to make adjustments.
The offensive rebound. The Clippers shooting it well here in the fourth quarter, 50%. Coffey passes to Batum. Shoots over Brown. Offensive rebound. Second shot opportunity. He can't hit that time. So the Trailblazers will take it the other way. Pass to Ellaby. Lays it up and banks it in. Ellaby's got 5 points now this quarter.
And look, he's not the best athlete, but he's able to create the space he needs to operate.
Coffey goes back up. And that one is good from Hartenstein.
And one of the stories of the second half has been all of those second chance points. I mean, they have been terrific on the offensive board.
To the middle, deflects the pass. Ellaby, the pass to Brown. And that one drops.
Yeah, well done to finish that one off.
They're making this a runaway.
And the only question for me right now is just how big the lead will eventually become.
Now here's McLemore outside. The rebound by Johnson. And Los Angeles guys shooting indicative of smooth offensive play. Up at 60%. They're a machine from the floor. And the shot is good.
Controlling the defensive glass has been a problem here tonight.
Portland's gone 3 of 5 from beyond the arc since the final quarter's gotten underway. Now here's McLemore. Snell, the pass to Ellaby. Back to Snell. Shot clock at 6. The shot from 20 feet away. Rebound by the Clippers. Hartenstein's got 4 rebounds now tonight. From deep 3-point range, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Trailblazers will take
it.
The Trailblazers shooting about 45% from the floor in the fourth. Ellaby, the pass to Brown. Basket counts.
Great. And even if you risk a foul, the D has to play him tougher when he gets it that deep.
And if you don't, they keep finding the matchup every time up the floor.
Now here's McLemore outside. That shot, no good. And the Clippers will come the other way. Johnson, that's for 2. It's hauled in by Brown.
2 minutes remaining.
Brown's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. To the paint. Here's McLemore. Count the bucket. Ben coming McLemore off a perfectly placed assist.
Tony
McLemore's got 4 points this quarter.
Passes like this demonstrate Snell's team-first approach. He's all about getting it to the open guys.
Keon Johnson assist.
And here's McLemore. He kicks it to Little. Down low. Here's Brown. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
That's a nice read. The value of keeping your eyes up.
Johnson outside. Stolen away. McLemore with the ball. And it's Johnson picking him up.
And as we head to the final buzzer here, a crushing blowout. Big time dominance. And this will go in the record books as a gaudy win for Los Angeles.
You don't see this kind of a blowout often, but tonight this is a quality win across the board to deliver out this kind of punishment.
They definitely never changed the approach. They just kept after it and showed they were clearly the better team in just about every single category.
And now for the year, this is going to take them to 7 wins. And one of the key components to this victory, if not the biggest, was the incredible performance for Reggie Jackson.
He affected the game so much with the way he was able to come out and get steals and extra possessions for his team.
Out of bounds, Portland takes possession.
Portland basketball.
George is checked in for the Clippers. And the Trailblazers making a change here as well. Cody Zeller's checked in for Ben McLemore. 44 seconds left in the fourth. Here's Snell, and it's denied. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Trailblazers will retain possession. Ben McLemore, he's checked in for Portland.
Ben McLemore.
Fires the three, buries the long-range jumper.
Yeah, coming down the stretch, they've become reliant upon their perimeter game.
You know, when you're raining threes, you can stack up points in a hurry, but it can go the other way as well.
The wide-open shot by Little, and again, it's the Trailblazers from deep.
3 points.
Here's George. That one's off, still out of sync. And so they foul intentionally.
Not sure what that was about. I mean, talk about a brain cramp.
Los Angeles calls timeout. They're ahead by 15. 15 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Guys, what do you think?
And the game pretty much over. Curious timeout here.
In my opinion, I think they're looking to make a substitution. But let's see out of the timeout.
Present our New Balance Player of the Game, Damian Lillard.
And to me, the best part of his game has been the work he's done inside. I mean, slashing, driving the lane, attacking the basket at every chance. When he's had an opening, he's taken it.
And so here's Portland, down by 15. Passes it to McLemore. Fires for three. Batum grabs the miss. At the elbow, it's George. And he uses the glass on the layup.
And you know they feel good giving their fans a show here while taking care of business.
They're going to win by a nice margin. The effort was there all night.
So it's Los Angeles winning this one easily. And the outcome of this one was never in doubt.
And boy, they really put in a supreme effort. It just felt like once they had that lead and it was comfortable, they were not going to relinquish it.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Hey, thanks, Kevin. PG, you guys look confident out there, and especially yourself. How were you so effective offensively?
I just kept moving. You know, within our offense, you know, the key is to move. You know, my teammates do a great job of setting screens and getting me open. You know, I just gotta, you know, stay within offense.
Well, it was great flow tonight, and it led to a good win, man. Congratulations. Kevin, all yours.
All right, David, thank you. Well, folks, that's gonna do it for now. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Steve Smith, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.